Hey guys, and welcome to my very first action figure review. This is a review of a figure I got for just 50% of the original retail price. This is the Transformers Reveal the Shield Bumblebee. And I chose to review this figure in celebration for the coming newer generations Bumblebee. It's the IDW 30th anniversary toy line, if I'm not mistaken. And I've seen the pictures. If you haven't seen the pictures, you can go search for them. They're awesome. Especially I'm just a big Bumblebee fan. Bumblebee is my favorite Transformer, and the coming figure, I just can't wait to get my hands on them. I just have to get it. So I chose to review something closest to that figure, which is this figure, which has a sort of classic G1 look, which is just actually an updated G1 look. So this figure also has a Takara Tomy version, but that was just too hard for me to get. So and this one was actually readily available and cheaper, so I chose to get this figure instead. This is the card for the packaging, which I kept. I've had this figure for about more than a year. In my opinion, the art in the back of the packaging is for once really similar to the final product. There's the vehicle mode and the Reveal the Shield logo for this toy line. Here's a closer look at the stats for Bumblebee. And here's the product insert that came with Bumblebee. They actually placed the rest of the toy line in this product insert, and I was really interested in getting more of the toys, but they too were on sale, and I think everyone else just started buying everything. These are actually the Voyager class figures, and these are the deluxe class figures, and there's actually an ad for Transformers 3. They didn't have a title yet, I think, that time. So you already know that they were already advertising the movie even before they had an official title. And here's a weird thing I saw. You could go back to that and look for what's wrong in that picture. This is the instruction manual that came with a figure. If you're having a hard time understanding how to transform the figure, it's okay, you can stop reading, and we're gonna transform the figure to robot mode and then vehicle mode again. So first, I'm glad that the wheels actually roll on this figure, because on some Bumblebee figures, when you put them in vehicle mode, the wheels don't really roll that much because they're not equally flat on the surface. So you can adjust this, and the rolling here is just fine. So first, you remove the door. They're actually kept together by some pegs that you can easily remove. Next, you push down the legs like so, then you pull out the arms and do the same at the other side, and separate the legs, and you open the flaps for the feet and just rotate them upward, like so. And do the same for the other leg. Push down the chest piece and flip down the knee pads and pull down the head. Now the doors are just sticking on the arm, so you're gonna wanna rotate them around and then just turn them to get the proper positioning, because there will be a peg that you can attach to the arm so the door stays in place. And you can do the same on the other arm. And there's Bumblebee. Really easy transformation. You can transform it any way you want. I just transformed it the way I want to. So it's really up to you to transform it. Here's the accessory that came with him. He only came with one accessory. I would have wanted him to get a gun, but they chose not to give him a gun, so it's okay. A booster is, a jetpack is just as fine. So you turn it around. Just after separating it, and then you position the wheels the way you want to. I'm just following the package art that came with the figure. So I'm not, you can really position it any way you want. Place it at the back. There's gonna be a hole from which there's a clip that could attach to that. Just clip it on there. The head has to be really straight. So the poseability of the head is actually hindered when you have the jetpack on. There's the Reveal the Shield logo. Here's a 360 view of the figure. The back is actually really similar to the War for Cybertron Bumblebee. And it's an okay figure. It's not ugly. It's not really visually stunning, but It's a good figure. I love the head sculpt. The head sculpt really gives me the G1 feel, which I really like in the figure. So, for articulation, there's really good head articulation if you remove the jetpack. Up, down, and side to side. No waist swivel. Arms go up, down, and side to side. There's a single jointed ball joint for the elbow. The hips have a ball joint, go side to side and forward and back. Goes back this far, and the feet, because of the transformation, has some articulation. So it's a decent figure, has decent articulation. The sculpt is really good. So now we'll transform it back to car mode. It's actually just a reverse of what we did earlier. So we fold the feet and join them together. Bring the head up and into the back of the car. Flip the chest piece up and pull the feet up towards the windshield. Now there's a vehicle revving outside my house. The door is flipped just the reverse of what we did earlier. And just position the door to the right place. Make sure that the wheel is pulled out properly. Forgot to position the seats. So just position that. And just clip it back to where they were earlier. So it's really easy. Just After positioning everything, just make sure everything's nice and tight. There's an issue here. If you can see, I thought it was just with my figure, but the front of the windshield is just actually just separated a bit. There's this gap, but I saw the pictures of other people's figures. It's the same, so I think it's really with the sculpt. It's not a big deal. For the jet ski attachment, just flip it and clip the two sides to each other, like so. And you're done. Really easy. Just position it right and you have your attachment back. So just there's a hole and just place it there and voila. Back to vehicle mode. So it's a really easy figure to transform. I think lots of people could enjoy the quality. It's not Takara quality for the paint job, but it's just as enjoyable. So I advise you to, if you're a Bumblebee fan, a Bumblebee collector, you can easily find this figure. I recommend it. Thanks for viewing and comment.